Yes, what's happening, people? Second video of the day. Been a little bit busy today. Had a couple of different things going on away from YouTube. So I've only just caught up on what's being said. So without any messing, let's get straight into the video. Yes, what's happening, people? Hope everyone's doing well. So a couple of little different things to discuss. First off, we'll start off in regards to the sheriff with this whole Reacher situation. Now, Sheriff's done a video before, it was 20 odd minutes, I didn't actually sit through it all. But he was trying to make out that he can see anybody off on YouTube, you know. Bosh, he deals with these, the left, right and centre. He reckons that the Reachers looked into the Sheriff and decided that, oh, he better give that one a swerve. Now, personally, Sheriff, I find that hard to believe. If I am 100% honest, we've all seen you on the bag. Absolutely useless. The clothes what you wear, you got out of them donation bags. And the fact that when you go to these events, you seem to like be desperate to try and get in photos with certain people. The fact that that Paddy clicks his fingers and you will run from one end of the country to the other to answer to the master's call to take him down the shop to get the local paper. Now, for me, that just shows what you are, Sheriff. You call me the desperado, you're desperate. Like you say, oh, it does your head in when I say I'm an A-lister, I'm a celebrity. And no, it makes us cringe. We cringe for you. Like at first we was telling you as if to say, like, come on, mate, it's a bit cringy that. But you just carried it on and it's just like, oh, what an idiot. Also, because like I say, I've been a bit busy, so I've only just noticed, Jimmy the Pooh did a 1 hour live today. He pretty much spoke about me the whole time from what I can gather. As I've skipped through, there's pretty much always comments on the screen about me and stuff. But a couple of things, what you were saying, what was just blatant out and out, like porky pies and lies. First, you was trying to say, oh, he seems to be fine to say what he wants about other people's families. But like moans when people, what have I said? Like moaned about what you have said about my family. You say that I moan when you do it to me. No, I don't. You know what I'm saying? Like, you, Jimmy, as well. You used to say loads of stuff about my family. What I said was the way you felt in regards to rubbing your mum's feet. Which leads me on to my next point. You've clearly still held that grudge for over a year. Four times you've said, oh yeah, this is squashed. And then at the first opportunity, you're back out making your videos. Like, your videos are proper terrible, by the way. Hence why no one's even watching them. Because they watch the first one. The second one, they know it's just the same as the first one. So it's like, it's pointless. Your content's rubbish, bro. You're on the live talking absolute lies about me. Just blatant lies, basically. Saying, I don't know how much, how many bills £300 YouTube pays. Well, I've told you what the £300 YouTube pays. It pays off my holiday payments each month. I'm not trying to tell you I'm making big bucks off it, but to spend 15 minutes a day talking to your phone and to get £300 a month, I'm quite happy with that. You know what I'm saying? Other people, you might think, oh, I don't need that 300 quid. Well, to be honest, that's 300 quid extra, like I say, that I haven't got to find. So I'm quite happy talking to my phone for 15 minutes a day for 300 nicker a month. But I have actually got a small little clip here. As we know, this all come about with Jimmy jumping out the woodwork this time because the fighting fly was leaving little comments here and there. I left a comment back to him. He sort of got his a bit butthurt, which you can't really do in this corner if someone leaves you a comment and then called me out and all the rest of it anyway, all spiraled, didn't it? And now we've ended up with Jimmy making the poo videos, what he does. But check out this little clip, what I've got of the last time Jimmy and the fighting gay pride, The Fly, met up.
Yeah, man, this is getting me so hot.
I don't see why you have to belittle me in front of people like that.
Hey, relax, guy.
Sometimes I think you don't have any respect for me.
Come here, guy. Who's my cream puff?
I am.
That's my buddy.
So, as you can see, their relationship is a bit more than friends, in my opinion. So, real ones, let me know what you think. Now, this whole Jimmy situation, for me, is pointless. I'm not going to be, like, responding to him and... It's pointless, man. All he'll do is try and make out, oh, after all, if I start making videos back to him, trying to down him, as we've all seen, he'll have a breakdown, pull his hair out again and start telling me he's coming here, he's coming there, he's going everywhere. None of yous are going anywhere. As I've said, I'm not a fighter. I'm not accepting any call-outs. I'm not making any call-outs. I did say in a comment the other day, I was hoping the sheriff was going to call me out, and I would have had that as my match. It's clearly not happened, but me saying that I am open to a match in this corner is probably what's bringing the irrelevant people trying to call me out. I'm not up for fighting someone for pennies, for £100, £200, £300. That's not worth my time. Despite how skinned you all seem to think I am, I'm not going to train for like days on end or weeks on end, spend money on gym things and to eat the right food. It costs me more money to get ready for the fight when I could just talk to my phone for 15 minutes a day and make more than fighting the plonkers. So John Paul's got it right. Don't be pretending that you just want to fight people when you don't. Let's not all forget people. Jimmy Newman's on here at the moment trying to portray yourself as, you know, this good guy. Before he started making the videos about me, 2 days ago, he was saying, oh, you should stop this, you should stop that, blah, blah, blah. You know, trying to make out he's a good guy, trying to fool the public again. But let's not forget, we all seen exactly what Jimmy Newman is about when he was going around Scotty G. Now, he, in my opinion, he was a big contributing factor to the beginning of the downfall of Scotty G. Scotty G was all right when he first come around Jimmy. We watched him decline on the lives and things. Jimmy's gone up there to see him. Whatever else has gone on then, he seemed to go on even more of a slide. Then they fell out and Jimmy has proceeded to log into Scotty's All Scotty's Things, delete his first channel. Then when Scotty's made another one, he's managed to get into that one and start changing all the titles on his videos, the pictures, you know, trying to proper mug the geezer off. Now, don't get me wrong. I have said from the beginning, I think it's good what's happening with Paddy. I think Scotty probably is on the road to recovery. My grievances lie with the fact that I believe they've probably had enough GoFundMe money now. And Sheriff and things are probably skimming off the top for certain things, what they do. That's where my grievances come in. I believe what Paddy's doing is spot on. But like I say, let's not forget who helped to contribute to putting that guy where he is. The one and only. The good guy. The people's champ, as he calls himself. Even though, in reality, he's only the champ in his mind, isn't he? As soon as he gets out of his living room, he's no longer the champ. But, real ones, you guys let me know what you think in the comments. We'll see you all on the next video. Hopefully, Reacher does reappear, because Sheriff is looking awfully smug about this whole situation, you know. So I am hoping the Reacher does pop back up and, yeah, just let him know that he's not gone anywhere. But we'll have to just see, won't we? Like I said, let me know what you think in the comments. We'll see you all on the next one. Peace.